again, and thank you for choosing to watch another instalment from my YouTube channel, Benidorm and Beyond. Today, I'm going to show you 10 minutes worth of befores and afters. There will, of course, be some that I have missed, didn't know about, or wasn't sure about, but I will catch these next time around. Some parts of the video may not be 100% accurate, but I have tried to be as precise as possible with all my information, as I always strive to be. Obviously, due to the before and after nature of this video, I had very little footage of the businesses before they were taken over. So, if necessary, I've included a photo of them instead. If you enjoy this vlog, please consider becoming a subscriber so you'll never miss any new content when I upload it in the future. So let's get started. We begin on Cae Londres in the Rincon de Loix area, with two neighbouring bars, the Stretford End and the London Bar. They have both disappeared and have been replaced by one huge bar called simply The Pub. In fact, the evening of the day that I recorded this footage, The Pub had its opening night. Next is one of my favourite shops, Tiger. Situated along Avenida Martínez de Lejos in the Old Town, this footage was recorded on the day of its closing down sale. Clearly many people had the same idea as me, to pick up one last bargain, as you can see by the queues. It has now been replaced by Spanish retailer Koala Bay, who specialise in summery clothes, footwear and accessories. Heading into Plaza Triangular, we used to find here the large pizza restaurant El Italiano. This has been replaced by another pizzeria, which is now called La Pia Montesa. Back up to Cae Londres, and on the right hand side here, you can see a bar previously known as Tio Loco. This has been transformed into another bar, this time called Twisted Cocktail, which is part of the Uncle Ron's chain, who are now taking Benidorm by storm. Moving along to the old town end of Calle Girona, or Food Street, we find that we have lost the restaurant Romero. This has been replaced by a new bar and restaurant with a British pub style theme called the Halfway House. Here we are on the corner of Calle Marte and Avenida de los Almendros, right up in the top of the old town area. This business was a large empty unit, but I'm unable to remember what business it was previously. Can you tell me? Now it is called Z-Man, which is often dubbed as the Dutch Primark and is a sizable shop selling all sorts of clothes and homeware at discount prices. Now we are back in the Rincon de Loix, along Calle Estocolmo. Here we see a pizzeria restaurant, Shantusi. This has been replaced by Taberna Mitica, which is a Bulgarian restaurant and specialises in ribs and grilled meats. Back in the old town again, along Avenida Almendros, we find a furniture and mattress shop called Ahora Total. This has closed and is now a bright and modern hairdresser's called Amor. Again we return to Cae Londres, this time to bar and restaurant El Brasas. This business was barely open 5 minutes before being replaced by another bar called Gemma's Sports Bar. Although nicely redecorated, sadly this has closed already too, and didn't even last the 5 minutes of the previous business. What a shame. Now we're on the main road coming into the Rincon de Loix on Avenida Ametlla del Mar. The Music Tavern, which had been closed for a long time, was completely renovated over a period of several months and is now replaced by the large Sun Terrace Bar. Down next to the sea, on Avenida Madrid, we find the previously popular Copacabana Beach and Saloon. It has made way for a new Valor Chocolateria. This cafe's speciality is thick hot chocolate served with churros, which is similar to donuts. Delicious. Back to the old town, on along Avenida Martínez de Lejos, we find a shop called Roberts. This has been replaced by a mobile phone accessory shop called La Casa de las Carcasas. Let's go back along to the Rincon de Loix and Calle Estocolmo. Here there was a tattoo shop called Risi, which has been replaced by a dog grooming parlour called Scrappy Coco. I'm sorry, but I couldn't find a full picture of Rissi, only a sign, which still remains. Now we walk just around the corner to Calle Londres and the Spanish bar and restaurant El Cortijo. This has been taken over by a new bar and restaurant called Panacea. Onwards to Avenida Juan Fuste Zaragoza, where the popular sports bar The Gallagate has disappeared. This has been replaced by another bar, which has been totally refurbished and is now called The 12th Man. Here we see the bottom of Calle Belin, opposite the well-known Triangle Pub. Here, the Indian restaurant, The Balti House, has been replaced by a supermarket called Udaco. Now we go back to Calle Gambo in the old town, and here we see a baby's clothing shop called Lobo Damos. This is now closed, and a new women's clothes retailer called Byron Bay has replaced it. Back again to Calle Londres, and this time the Indian bar and restaurant called The Empire. This has been reopened as a new bar called Uncle Ron's, which is proving to be a popular eatery. Along Calle Girona once again, we find Cocona Restaurant and Lounge. This has been replaced by a brand new Pizza Hut. This seems a little odd to me, as only 20 metres away is a Pizza Express, but as the Spanish do love their pizza nearly as much as the Italians, maybe there's room for everyone. Just along from the new Pizza Hut, on Calle Girona, used to be a bar called Trotters International Traders. This has now been replaced by a new bar called Popeyes. Now we walk to the top of Carrer de Tomás Ortuño, near El Cruce in the Old Town. Here we find that Meson Manolo has been replaced by another Spanish tapas bar called La Truita de Iván. Back in the new town, beneath shopping complex La Noria, we find ourselves back on Calle Girona. We can see that the Curry Mile has gone, and in its place has appeared Tepuy Burger, a burger restaurant and takeaway which has outstanding reviews. Again, along Calle Girona, and this time next door to Scruffy Murphy's Bar, the Tattooists has disappeared. This has been replaced by a kebab shop and restaurant called Kebabish Masala. Onto the beachfront now, and we can see that the Bombay Beach Casbah Bar has been replaced by Lounge Bar Hotspot, overlooking the sea. Also, just a little further along the promenade, on Avenida Madrid, we see pizzeria restaurant Toca. This has been replaced by a new drinks and snack bar called Chiringuito Beach. Just around the corner from Chiringuito, along Avenida Castello, we find a waffle parlour called the Royal Waffle. This is now gone and is a new bar called TK Beach, which faces the Veracruz supermarket. A little further along Avenida Castello, we see the beach lounge has changed hands and has been reopened as Celtic Bar, Bar 67. Back in the Rincón de Loix and down Avenida Juan Fuste Zaragoza, we see Pica y Come. This drinks and tapas bar has been replaced by another Spanish bar, this time called Casa Pepe, which used to be along Avenida Dr. Severa Ochoa. Now we visit Calle Belin, and just up from English cabaret bar The Plaza was a Spanish bar called the Europa Center. This has now been taken over, and after a smart refurbishment, is now called Mom's. are again by Plaza Triangular in the Old Town, where a cafe-restaurant previously called Volapie has gone and has been replaced by another cafe-restaurant, this time called Terra y Mar. Back along Avenida Castillo once more, and here we see what used to be the Union Jack 2 British Bar. This has now been replaced and is called the Tartan Bar. In the Rincon de Loix, and just down the hill from the Magic Rock Gardens Hotel, we used to find Bar 1. This has now been turned into a laundrette called Low Cost. Towards the Old Town, along Avenida Mediterraneo, we can see here an estate agent called Triumph Group. This has been replaced by a shop called Tramas, which sells bedding, curtains and other homeware. And here we find that Albert and Franks, a well-known chain of hairdressers, has disappeared. These premises have been turned into a takeaway venue, simply called My Chips. Finally, we move over to the Poniente side of the resort and along Calle San Pedro, where we find a cafe-restaurant called Isla de Benidorm. Situated right next door to the H10 Hotel, and named after Benidorm Island, it has now been taken over by the Saltoki Group. It will reopen soon as another one of their no doubt popular bar and restaurants. I hope that you have enjoyed this tour of the new bars and businesses in town that you may not have seen in the last year or so, and let's hope that they all have a successful future ahead of them. If you did enjoy the video, I would ask that you please give it a thumbs up and like it, and consider subscribing to my channel if you haven't already done so. Also, feel free to drop me a line in the comments section if there is something or somewhere you would particularly like me to include in the future, and as always, I'll see what I can do. For those of you who have only just found my channel, Benidorm and Beyond, I enjoy not only videoing the bustling resort of Benidorm, but also the beautiful local area, including the nearby villages and towns, which can mostly all be reached by local transport at very reasonable prices. I'll see you out and about next time. Cheers!